Well, that conversation lends itself to this conversation. The actor Jake McDorman has been in a variety of projects, both for television and for the big screen, starring right now in the incredible space story, The Right Stuff, for Disney Plus. Jake, let's key off of the conversation we just had with our business reporter there, David Lazarus. When you're making American Sniper or some other big screen movie, is there any distinction in the production process between that and, say, this, The Right Stuff, which was for streaming?
Not so much. I mean, the productions are pretty similar. I guess the main difference is the length of time it takes to shoot. And with a movie like that, you have a clear beginning, middle, and end, where a series can remain open-ended. So you're kind of learning about your character as you go along. But for the most part, the production side of it, I'd say, is pretty similar. I mean, both of them are great. I'm a huge fan of television. I'm a huge fan of movies in the theater. Obviously, we can't do that safely right now. So it's a bummer. I miss it.
This very real prospect, though, of theaters going away. Do you have a thought about that?
Yeah, I would hate for that to happen. I mean, I would hope that would, you know, never happen in places like New York and LA, at least. You know, having both of those cities just revolve around the entertainment industry in so many different ways. But yeah, that would be crushing. I mean, I've been going to the theater since I was a little kid in like the 80s. So, I mean, I think the first movie I saw was the animated Oliver and Company with Joey Lawrence doing the voice of the cat. So however long ago that was, that's how long I've been going to a theater. But I don't know if vinyl comes back, even though we've got, you know, digital music and I've got a record player, and I know a lot of people my age and even younger that do. So I'm hoping that, you know, a nostalgia for the theater will kind of make it through.
That's a good point. Speaking of nostalgia, The Right Stuff, we know the book, we know the original film. What distinguishes this project?
I think, you know, one of the things is just real estate. Also, if you look at real estate, meaning like 8 hours to adapt the book, you know, into a series rather than 2.5-3 hours for a movie. I think that's one of the great things about technology and filmmaking catching up in TV, where it's been in movies that you can tell these kind of more ambitious stories, like, you know, a Game of Thrones or a story about going to space on television just as easily and technologically competent as you could in the movie traditionally. So we just have more time to really get into the weeds with who these guys are, to learn about their families, the effect this had on their families. And also, if you want to like bookend it, the way I think about it is, you know, we had the first manned SpaceX launch March of this year. Last year was the 50th anniversary of the moon landing in Apollo 11, and our story predates Apollo by two more space programs. So before Apollo, we had Gemini, and before Gemini is Mercury, which is the story we're telling now. So it serves as a good spectrum of where we are today and then how the space program in America started.
Even though it's way back when you put on that space suit, because I think, you know, we all want to be a cowboy. We all certainly want to be an astronaut. What did that feel like?
Well, it was in Florida in July, so it was really, really hot. There's no way to pee in that thing, and there's no way to get it on or off without four people helping you. But aside from that, total wish fulfillment. I was a little kid in that thing.
Really looks good. The Right Stuff, streaming now on Disney+. Jake, thanks for talking with us this morning. From that to Jessica and Frank.
All right, Sam. Thank you.